Hey everybody. All right, so this is my first video like this. I can only imagine it's going to be incredibly rough around the edges, but I think maybe it'll be fun too, and I'm really looking forward to doing it. So this is going to be what I originally considered a how-to video, but it's not really how-to because I only kind of know what I'm doing. So it's more like a video of me trying to figure out exactly what I'm going to be doing kind of in the middle of doing it. But just to give you an idea, I am in the process of installing a dual battery system in this, my 100 series Land Cruiser. Her name's Black Betty. I love her very much. And the dual battery system is going to be, you know, two batteries in the front under the hood. We're gonna run some cable to the back, and we're gonna establish a power point here in the rear. So real quick, I'll show you what we've done so far, and then I'll show you all the equipment that I have and all the parts that I've been assembling, and I'll give you an idea of what it is I'm going to do as a whole, and then, you know, we'll get started. So first, under the hood, we have the two batteries. Right here is what we call the starter battery. And I've already installed a Slee oversized battery tray. And this is a Group 31 battery, which is basically about the largest battery that you can fit under the hood of a Land Cruiser without, you know, maybe some serious modifications. And then over here, my good friend Sam Moore helped me fabricate this battery tray that you can see down there. He made it from scratch with a welder and a grinder, and he did an excellent job. And this is what you would call the house battery, and this is a Group 34 battery. And we actually, in order to complete this modification, we had to weld the mount for this power steering reservoir to the side of the battery tray. So that power steering reservoir sits right there between the battery and this engine cover. So today we'll be installing a Red Arc DC to DC charger. And that Red Arc DC to DC charger will go down here in front of the radiator. I swear there's like a jet flying over and a four-wheel drive. Oh, everybody, say hi to Avie. So, we're gonna look at all the parts that I have assembled today to complete all these tasks. First, probably the most important, the brain of the DC to DC charger is this Red Arc charger here. This goes in the front, it's gonna connect the two batteries, and it's basically a smart charger that tells the starter battery when and how to charge the house battery. And also it acts as an isolator so that the house battery can't overdraw the starter battery and run it down. And then this is some hardware for that DC to DC charger. This is for the house battery. This is some nylon cable coverings so we can stick the cable inside this to protect it. Shrink wrap right here. The shrink wrap is, you know, you use to protect the ends of the connectors of the cables when you make them. Cable connector kit. This is a fuse hub. So when we get to the back here, if you look right here, there's this little flap. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run a cable from the house battery back here, and then I'm gonna mount this fuse hub inside here like this, and that will be an additional power point so I can connect things like my refrigerator, my light bar, my rear lights, work lights, basically anything that I need 12 volt DC power for. And along with that is gonna be this panel, which I'm gonna mount right here. And inside this panel is a 12 volt DC charger, and also a pair of 2.1 amp USB chargers, along with a voltmeter, so I can see, you know, so I can monitor the voltage. Right here we have this bus bar. This will be used to ground the vehicle, or to ground the electronics in the back. I'll mount it roughly over here somewhere, and then like right in here in this area, there's a factory ground where I can ground everything. And this is a circuit breaker. This will go between the house battery and the fuse block. And then over here we have various size of cable. We got 25 feet of 8 gauge, 25 feet of 8 gauge black cable, 25 feet of 8 gauge red cable, 15 feet of 6 gauge, and 15 feet of 6 gauge. This is going to be used for between the house and the starter battery. This primarily will be used for grounding, and also the red cable will be used to connect the house battery to the fuse block in the rear. So yeah, this is going to be a long project, but it's probably going to take me the better part of 2 days. And as I go, I got this stuff here. I think this is kind of interesting. It's called Kill Mat, and what this is it's some fancy high-tech insulator sound deadener. So as I pull the carpet up and as I pull the siding off the inside here, I'm going to lay this insulation and sound deadener down before I replace everything. And then the final step will be, once I get the fuse block in and I get all the cable ran and I get everything grounded, I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna pull out this rear seat. Is what they call a 70-30. So this is 70% is this piece, 30% is this piece. I'm gonna pull out this 30% piece like so, and I'm gonna take this part completely out, and I'm gonna install a refrigerator right here so that it is nominatively accessible both from the rear door, but also from the front seat, and it won't take up any storage space either in or on my shelf system. So yeah, big plans. I'm excited. I'm to get started. So let's go. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do, what I already did was I took some cables here on this DC to DC charger and I isolated the ones that we're not gonna use. These are the three that we're gonna use. We're gonna use the red one, which is going to go to the starter battery, the brown one, which is gonna go to the house battery, and the black, which is a ground. So to get started, I'm going to put a connector on the end of this ground so I can ground it to the chassis. And then I'm going to use these little connectors here to connect some 8 gauge cable to the red and black here and run those to the house and starter batteries. And then once I get close to the battery, I'm going to use these fuses, and I'm going to put fuses between the DC to DC charger and the battery. These are 40 amp fuses. They come with the Red Arc kit. All right, so I took this DC charger and I fixed all these cables. I put this shielding on the cables and I used these shrink wraps to moisture protect them, where I crimped all the connectors on, and then I connected, there's connectors in here, right? And these are ready to be installed. And one of these red cables is gonna go to the house battery, and one's gonna go to the starter battery, and this is gonna go to the ground. So the first thing I gotta do is remove the grill. This leans forward. And there's these little tabs. You just click the little tabs, it comes right out. And then I had previously already mounted this DC charger mount. I plastic coated it and then mounted it, as you can see right here. And this
It's gonna go right on here like this. So, what did I do with my hardware? Should go on pretty easily. This is the world debut of my new glasses. I don't know, do they make me look smart? Maybe I'll put up a poll. Charger tightened down. It's pretty secure. It's designed to be mounted here in front of the radiator to help with the cooling. And now I have to figure out exactly where I'm going to ground it. I can ground it anywhere on the chassis here. Okay, so I got a bunch of zip ties. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to secure these cables to these hoses right here. And I'm going to secure this cable here. This cable's running behind, this cable's gonna run behind the red arc device, underneath the radiator, between the clamp that attaches the, looks like this is the transmission cooler, to the frame, and then up through this hole to here. And when I get here, I'm gonna have to take this fuse here, I'm gonna put that fuse on the end of this cable, attach a cable to the other end of the fuse and connect it to my positive terminal right here. On the other side, I'm going to do the same thing. As you can see, this cable's going to come through here. I routed it underneath this hardware that's secured to the chassis and up through here. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to attach it to this fuse and then from the other fuse, attach it to the military terminal on the top of this battery. All right, so I finally got this cable run. I got that side all terminated. The hardest part is figuring out where I'm gonna attach these fuses. So what I decided to do here was I ran this cable along another electrical bundle and I secured it in the same place that electrical bundle was secured. And then I'm gonna terminate this right here and I'm gonna use this zip tie to attach the fuse directly to the battery. Going to go there, and then this one is going to go right into there, and I think I'm going to feed this cable underneath.
Baby,
I am all done under the hood for now. Over here, we have the starter battery. There's your 40 watt amp coming from the DC charger to the positive military terminal on the starter battery. I installed a new ground. This is a 6-gauge ground. This needs to be replaced, but the problem is it goes into this bundle, this electrical bundle here, and goes way into the frickin' back, and I don't know exactly where it goes, and that's gonna have to be a project for another day, because that's I think that's gonna be a little time consuming. Cable runs down through here, out up through here. There's your ground for the red arc. Here's your live cable going to the house battery. Like I told you earlier, I found another electric bundle and I just traced that electrical bundle and I secured this power cable to the other electrical cable. And it comes up over here to the house battery. We have another 40 watt amp, or another 40 watt fuse rather, or 40 amp fuse right here. I secured that to the top of the battery with a zip tie, and then I ran the cable underneath this, the battery holder, so this is pretty secure. I ground this down here. There's a chassis ground down here you probably can't see, but I grounded it right there. And I need to screw that back in, but it should work. So let's go fire up the engine and see if the starter battery is charging the house battery.
I'm like, how is he doing this?
It's good. So if you look over here, you've got your lights flashing, charge status, vehicle. So that's how I know that the starter battery is charging the house battery. So far, a success. All right, so this has been the fun part. I pulled this back quarter panel off the back here, and took out, as you can see, I took out that seat. This was much harder to get off than I expected, and my hands are bleeding a lot, but I got it. I'm gonna pull this carpet up. I'm gonna put down that insulation, and then I'm going to start installing the fuse block in that panel that I took off. Here, you can see I ran this cable. Wasn't as hard as I expected. I had to punch a small hole down there and run this cable through. I pushed it through just a bit, and then I actually had to punch a hole on the other side as well. I used a box cutter, and I pulled it through with a pair of needle-nose pliers, and I ran it down through here. I had to take this panel off, and I took this off. It's down here on the ground, and you can see I ran the cable, see the cable, through here. Getting it through here was a pain as well. I couldn't figure out how to get this thing off. Everything else just pops off. This wouldn't pop off, but eventually I shoved it through, and now this cable is gonna go up into here like this. And that's what's next. All right, so now I have all of this kill mat in. It's a insulator and sound deadening. If you pull this back here, you can see it's like a black sticky substance. It's kind of like tar, and it's really easy to install. It just lays down perfectly flat and sticks, and you can just like run it over everything. So I got it all over the wheel well there and on the inside. I didn't do this yet, At some point, I'm gonna have to take this cover off, but I don't have to take it off now, so I think I'm just gonna leave it. Plus, there's not a lot of exterior showing underneath this because the Bose subwoofer is right there, so that covers up a lot of the space, just like the air conditioning, the rear air compressor covers up a lot over here. And this part I can get to, and I may go ahead and do that one. So next I'm going to try to get underneath this carpet here and see what's holding these things on. These are the braces that was holding the rear seat in, and I can't find what's keeping these here. I need this to be flat so I can set the refrigerator down on it. All right, so now I'm going to take this fuse block and I'm going to mount it right here. And then I'm going to take this and I'm going to mount it right there. That is my next job. Covering up the holes, so if they're ugly it doesn't really matter. I will let you guys laugh at me from the comfort of your own homes. So I went and I bought these screws with the intention of mounting this fuse block on here with these screws, but the screws don't go in the little holes. Luckily the screws only cost $1. I'm gonna have to go to Lowe's tomorrow and get some that fit. But in the meantime, I can drill out the rest. I wonder if the screws fit this thing. No, that's even smaller. All right, so tomorrow I gotta take these with me to Lowe's, as I should have done today. And that way I can test the screws and make sure that they're the appropriate size. Because the bezel will cover up the cut job, it doesn't have to be super pretty work, which is perfect for me because I am not particularly good at the detail stuff. So now you get to see me, as soon as I drill this out, you're gonna get to see me use a Dremel for the first time. I went and bought it at Harbor Freight. It was like $15. And I've never used one before. Now we're ready to cut. I think. Bam! Here's the bad news. After all that cutting, didn't even go all the way through. I'm gonna need to get something like a mini jigsaw or something. I think this is done. Yeah, see, I gotta cut through the second layer. And I'm out of Dremel heads. So, in addition to extra screws tomorrow, gotta go buy more Dremel heads. You know, that's not terrible. That is not terrible. I can totally live with that. And when you consider the fact, remember, the bezel's gonna cover it up, right? Nobody's ever gonna see it. It's just a matter of my own pride here and exposing my lack of fine eye-hand coordination to the world. But tomorrow, I'll get another blade and I'll cut through that second layer along with the extra screws. And I think I'm about to call it a night. Yeah, we'll start again tomorrow morning. All right, so we're back for day two. I had to add the hat because the sun is shining and I got a bald head and I sunburned the top of my head yesterday. So if you remember last night, we ended up with the Dremel and I broke that little blade that came with it. So today I went and bought a new, more robust blade and I'm gonna finish cutting this out, installing the panel. I'm going to install the fuse block. I'm going to install the ground and the bus back over here somewhere behind this air compressor. And then I'm going to hook the power cable up and I'm going to install the breaker up near the house battery. And I'm going to put the carpet back in, remount this, and then try to see if I can fit that refrigerator in and get the refrigerator grounded properly. So here we go. All right, so we are set back up with a new and improved Dremel cutting blade. So in theory, I should be able to slice through this like a hot knife through butter, and then we will go ahead and mount the stuff, drill some holes. You'll see. Maybe I should have just done that from the start. We are just about done.
done that a long time ago. Now we're going to do the same thing to the bus here, but without all the difficulties of cutting a hole in it. Beautiful. So now we're going to drill a hole on this side for the power cable to come in. I'm going to drill a hole on this side for the grounding cable to go out. Okay, so next, we're gonna take this cable that's coming through the firewall, and we're gonna add this circuit breaker to it, and I'm gonna mount this circuit breaker right here. Right there, on that little bolt right there. And then we're gonna run it to this positive terminal here, and that will give power to that fuse block in the back. Okay, so next, we're gonna take this cable that's coming through the firewall, and we're gonna add this circuit breaker to it, and I'm gonna mount this circuit breaker right here. Right there, on that little bolt right there. And then we're gonna run it to this positive terminal here, and that will give power to that fuse block in the back. So here we go. All right, so I have terminated the final two cables that are going into this rear quarter panel back here. You can see red on the left, black on the right. The red is coming from the front. The black I have grounded on the chassis down here. If you look underneath this kill mat, I ground the chassis right there. You see that? And then I just snaked that cable up behind this quarter panel. So now I'm
now I'm just gonna remount this quarter panel, and then I will terminate those cables on that fuse block.
All right.
Okay, so I'm done installing this fuse block. This is the ground cable that's grounded right down here that I showed earlier. The big red and black cable is the power cable that's running from the house battery. This black cable here is the ground for this power panel. And this red cable is the power cable coming from the fuse block that's gonna plug in right here. Now I don't have the circuit breaker under the hood turned on, but I'm gonna go turn the circuit breaker on under the hood, and I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna hit that power button. And when I do that, this light should come on, and this should say 12.6, 7, 8, or 9 volts. And if that happens, then we're in business. So let's go turn the breaker on. Ugh. All right. Breaker's on. We should have power in the rear now. And the moment of truth, we have power. So as you can see, the power light's on, and that says 12.9 volts. So we're good. We are good. I'm gonna bring out the refrigerator and set it in here, see what it looks like, and start putting some of this shit back together. Put these tools away, put the carpet in, and we're just about done. This is a great success. Okay, so I got the refrigerator in, and I got the carpet down, I got the whole thing put back together, and so I guess now's the big reveal. If you look over here, I got the fridge plugged into the 12 volt socket, and then if you come around here to the side door, where I took out that seat, we have a Engel combi fridge freezer, and you just pop the top and bam, we've got a refrigerator and a freezer. I put some water bottles in here so I could test them overnight, and in the morning check and see if the one side is cold and the other side's frozen. I have some tie-down straps on order so I can secure this right here. I'm gonna use the mounts where the seat used to sit to secure this in place. This seat won't be able to back up any more than, not much more than it is right now. It's level with mine, so that means that somebody who's 5'10 or less should be fine. They won't be able to lay the seat down, and if a tall person gets in, well, they might just be fucked. And I have two more small projects for the electrical system. If you look up here, I've already installed the light bar, and I'm going to run the power cable from the light bar probably down and through the firewall again. The power will go back to the fuse block, and then up here I'm going to install some switches. One switch for the light bar, three extra for I don't know what yet. Maybe ditch lights, maybe winch, maybe both, something else, I don't know. And then finally, because I use this tailgate as my work area and it doesn't get any light, I ordered some pod lights. I ordered these pod LEDs here. Right here. And I'm going to take these and I'm going to stick them up here. So that then I'll take them, I'll put an on-off switch like right here. So I can click, hit the on switch, boom, lights will shine down. Lights down. That will be later this week. All right, so that's the end of my first how to slash watch me try to do something I've never done before video. It ended pretty successfully. Not much damage to anything except to my hands and the occasional scratch to the interior. I hope you found this moderately educational or mildly entertaining. And if you did, I guess this is the time where I say hit subscribe, and I will surely be making some more.